हेलो एवरीवन, नाउ लेट अस सी वन न्यूमेरिकल फॉर द नाइक्वेस्ट प्लॉट. एक्चुअली सम स्टूडेंट्स आर फेसिंग प्रॉब्लम इन न्यूमेरिकल फॉर द नाइक्वेस्ट प्लॉट. सो हियर वी विल डिस्कस द सॉल्यूशन फॉर द गिवन न्यूमेरिकल. हियर वी हैव ओपन लूप ट्रांसफर फंक्शन. इट इज के अपॉन एस टू द पावर 3 एस टी प्लस 1. And we want to draw the Nyquist plot, and also we want to determine the stability for the closed loop system according to Nyquist stability criteria. In previous video class already I told you how we can draw the Nyquist plot. So to draw the Nyquist plot, first we have to define the Nyquist contour or Nyquist path, and according to the principle of argument, already I told you, Nyquist path or Nyquist contour does not pass through the singular point of f of s, that is poles at the origin or poles on the j omega axis of open loop transfer function g of s or g of s h of s. So here we have poles at the origin. We have three poles at the origin. That's why we have Nyquist contour according to the diagram. So here path will not cross the singular point, means pole present at the origin. So path will bypass the origin, or path will bypass the singular point present at s equal to 0. So we have Nyquist contour according to the diagram. Horizontal axis will define sigma, vertical axis will define j omega. So we can divide Nyquist path into four sections: section C1, section C2, section C3, and section C4. Already I told you, to draw the Nyquist plot, we will map each section from S plane to GH plane. So let us see mapping of section C1. So along section C1 of the Nyquist contour, we can say we have section C1 on the J omega axis. So we have s equal to j omega, and here omega will vary from 0 to infinity, because at this point we have value j infinity, at this point we have value minus j infinity. This is a positive imaginary axis and this is negative imaginary axis. So we have minus j infinity. And here we have minus j 0 minus, here we have plus j 0 plus. And semicircle, we can say first semicircle. For first semicircle, we have radius 0. Suppose it is epsilon. So you can say epsilon is 0. And for outer semicircle and for larger semicircle, we have radius, suppose capital R equal to infinite. So here we are talking about section C1. So you can say we have section C1 on the j omega axis. So we can say we have s equal to j omega. And here omega will vary from 0 to infinity or 0 plus to infinity. Let us define open loop transfer function at s equal to j omega. So if we will put s equal to j omega in given open loop transfer function, we have gj omega hj omega equal to k over j omega power 3 j omega t plus 1. So we can define magnitude. So here for numerator polynomial, we have magnitude k. And for denominator polynomial, for first term, we have magnitude omega power 3. And for second term, we have magnitude under root real square, means 1. Imaginary square means omega square t square. Similarly, we can define phase angle. For numerator polynomial, we have 0 degree. And for denominator polynomial, for the first term, we have phase angle minus 270 degree. Because here we have power 3. That's why we have phase angle minus 90 into 3 means minus 270 degree. Because we have j omega in denominator polynomial, so we have phase angle minus 270 degree. And for second term, means j omega t plus 1, we have phase angle 10 inverse imaginary upon real means omega t over 1. Or you can say you have term in denominator polynomial, so we have minus 10 inverse omega t. So phase angle becomes minus 270 degree minus 10 inverse omega t. This is my second equation. And magnitude equation means first equation. Now let us see, for omega equal to 0, we have magnitude infinity from first equation, and for omega equal to infinity, we have magnitude 0 from first equation. Similarly, for omega equal to 0, from second equation, we have phase angle minus 270 degree, and for omega equal to infinity, from second equation, we have phase angle minus 270, minus 90 means minus 360 degree. Now let us see how we can map section C1 from S plane to GH plane. So in GH plane, horizontal axis will define real GH, vertical axis will define imaginary GH. This is 0 degree line, minus 90 degree line, minus 180 degree line, minus 270 degree line. And 0 degree will also define minus 360 degree line. So here we have a phase angle from minus 270 to minus 360 degree for omega equal to 0 to infinity. For omega equal to 0 to infinity. And from second equation, we cannot define any value of omega between 0 to infinity for which we have phase angle minus 270 degree. That's why you can say plot will not cross the minus 270 degree line. So here we have initial phase angle minus 270 degree for omega equal to 0. And final phase angle minus 360 degree for omega equal to infinity. So we can say we have a graph in first quadrant. We have graph in first quadrant for omega equal to 0, magnitude in infinity. And for omega equal to infinity, magnitude is 0. That's why plot will end at the origin. Because at origin, we have 0 value. So this is a mapping of section C1 from Nyquist path or from Nyquist contour to GH plane. Now let us see mapping of section C3. So if we will see section C3, we can say for section C3, we have S equal to minus J omega. and omega will vary from infinity to 0 minus, because already we are considering s equal to minus j omega. That's why I am saying omega will vary from infinity to 0 minus. Infinity to 0 minus or infinity to 0. So if we will see section C3, we can say mapping will be mirror image about the real axis in GH plane corresponding to section C1. Because for section C3, we have s equal to minus j omega, and omega will vary from infinity to 0. Or if we consider s equal to j omega, you can say omega will vary from minus infinity to minus 0. So we can say mapping will be mirror image about the real axis in GH plane corresponding to section C1. In previous numerical already we discussed the same concept. So here we have a mapping of section C3 according to the diagram. It is mirror image of first diagram, or mirror image about the real axis in GH plane corresponding to section C1. Sign we will consider just reverse, means from omega equal to infinity to omega equal to 0, because omega is varying from infinity to 0. That's why direction we are considering from omega equal to infinity to omega equal to 0. So this is a mapping of section C3 from S plane to GH plane. Now let us see section C4. So along section C4, already I told you, along section C4, already I told you, we have a semicircle of 0 radius, and we are considering a radius as epsilon. So for section C4, we can write S equal to limit epsilon tends to 0 epsilon e to the power j theta, and theta will vary from minus 90 to plus 90 through 0 degree. If we will see section C4, we can say theta will vary from minus 90 to plus 90 through 0 degree, because it will cross 0 degree line. And here we have phase angle minus 90 degree. Here we have phase angle plus 90 degree. That's why we can say along C4, phase angle will vary from minus 90 to plus 90 through 0 degree. And we are saying according to the direction. According to the direction for C4. So phase angle, or you can say theta, will vary from minus 90 to plus 90 through 0 degree. So let us define GH for S equal to epsilon e to the power j theta. We have limit epsilon tends to 0 k over epsilon e to the power j theta power 3 into epsilon e to the power j theta t plus 1. Here we are just putting S equal to limit epsilon tends to 0 epsilon e to the power j theta in given open loop transfer function. We know here epsilon goes to 0, That's why in second term, B can neglect epsilon e to the power j theta t as compared to 1. So we have k over epsilon e to the power j theta power 3 into 1. Or from this, we can write magnitude as limit epsilon tends to 0 k over epsilon power 3. So we have magnitude infinity. And phase angle we can define with the help of equation 1 over e to the power 3 j theta or according to e to the power minus 3 j theta. So here we have phase angle minus 3 theta because in polar form we have r e to the power j theta. Theta will define phase angle. So here we have phase angle minus 3 theta. We know theta will vary from minus 90 to plus 90 through 0 degree. Let us put theta equal to minus 90 degree. So we have phase angle plus 270 degree. For 90 degree, we have phase angle minus 270 degree. And for 0 degree, we have phase angle 0 degree. So we can say theta will vary from plus 270 to minus 270 through 0 degree. Through 0 degree. So we can map section C4 from S plane to GH plane according to semicircle of infinite radius, and angle will vary from plus 270 to minus 270 through 0 degree. Now let us consider section C2. So along C2, already I told you, for C2 we have infinite radius and theta will vary from 90 to minus 90 degree. If we will see section C2, you can say we have infinite radius. Let us consider radius be capital R. And phase angle, we can say it will vary from plus 90 to minus 90 through 0 degree. Because C2 will cross 0 degree line. So we can map section C2 according to S equal to limit R tends to infinity R e to the power j theta. So let us put a value of S in given open loop transfer function. So we have equation. In equation for second term present in denominator polynomial, B can ignore 1 as compared to r e to the power j theta because here r goes to infinity. So we have limit r tends to infinity r square e to the power 4 j theta. So magnitude we can calculate according to limit r tends to infinity k over r square. So we have magnitude 0, and phase angle we can define according to e to the power minus 4 j theta. So here we have phase angle minus 4 theta. We know theta will vary from 90 to minus 90. So for 90, we have minus 360 degree. And for minus 90, we have 360 degree. For 0 degree, we have 0 degree. So theta will, you can say, phase angle will vary from minus 360 degree to plus 360 degree through 0 degree. But here we have magnitude 0. Here we have magnitude 0. So we can say entire semicircle C2 in S plane is mapped into a circular arc of radius 0 at the origin in the GH plane. Here we have magnitude 0. That's why we can say entire semicircle C2 in S plane or from S plane is mapped into a circular arc of radius 0 at the origin in the GH plane. Because at the origin we have 0 value. That's why this section from S plane to GH plane is mapped according to circular arc of 0 radius at the origin in the GH plane. Now we have mapped all sections from S plane to GH plane. So to define the Nyquist plot, we will combine the mapping of section C1, C2, C3 and C4. After that we have complete Nyquist plot. So let us see how we can define complete Nyquist plot. Horizontal will define real GH, vertical will define imaginary GH. This is 0 degree line, minus 90, minus 180, minus 270. Already we have seen mapping of section C1. Already we have seen mapping of section C3. We have seen mapping of C2, mapping of C4. Mapping of C2, we can say at the origin. And mapping of C2 according to point at the origin. And mapping of C4, we have a semicircle of infinite radius, but phase angle will vary from plus 270 to minus 270. And here we have plus 270. This is omega equal to 0 minus. Here we have omega equal to 0 plus. But for section C4, we have phase angle from plus 270 to minus 270. That means if we will define phase difference, we can say we have phase difference 540 degree. And for semicircle, we have phase difference 180 degree, means you can say plus 90 to minus 90 through 0 degree, or minus 90 to plus 90 through minus 180 degree. But here we have phase difference 540 degree, means we have one complete circle and one semicircle. 360 degree plus 180 degree. Now let us see how we can define mapping of C4. And we know we have a phase angle plus 270 to minus 270 through 0 degree. That's why here I am starting from this point, because this line will define a 270 degree line. And we have through 0 degree. So we have completed 360 degree. But phase difference is 540 degree, 540 degree. So let us define semicircle. Direction, we can say in clockwise direction. Because of passing through 0 degree line. So here we have Nyquist plot according to the diagram. This is Nyquist plot. To determine stability according to Nyquist stability criteria, we will first locate a critical point minus 1 comma J0, and obviously you know for section C4 we have infinite radius, so minus 1 comma J0 will lie inside the inner circle and as well as outer circle. According to Nyquist stability criteria, we have formula n equal to z minus p. N means number of n circle means we can say here Nyquist plot n circles the critical point by 2 times in clockwise direction. So we have n equal to 2. P means number of poles for open loop system in right half of S plane, and according to given open loop transfer function we don't have any pole in right half of S plane, so P becomes 0. That's why we have Z equal to 2. Z equal to 2 means we have 2 poles for the closed loop system in right half of S plane. That's why system becomes unstable. That means number of poles for closed loop system present in right half of S plane. So here we have 2 poles for closed loop system in right half of S plane. That's why system becomes unstable. P means number of poles for open loop system present in right half of S plane, and according to the given open loop transfer function we can say we don't have any pole in right half of S plane. That's why P becomes 0. N means number of n circle means, so here Nyquist plot n circles critical point means minus 1 comma J0 by 2 times in clockwise direction. That's why we have capital N equal to 2. Thank you.